we've got to do is wait for Mr. Claggett, this big radio celebrity here, to meet us at the hall. What you doing there, Bruce?
Putting some oil in the beast.
God, don't you ever wash that thing?
Oh, people, come on down.
Come on down.
Come on down. I'll tell you all about my engine here. See this? This is a Ford 302. Show you what, children. Show you how to pour. Show you how to pour some oil in here, children. See, you don't have to measure it in old 77 Ford LTDs, because you know that it's burned it already. You know there's nothing in there.
Oh, okay. Let's get a shot of that. Good sludge from the engine. Well, Bruce, where are we now?
Well, Dave, this here is the Quesnel District Recreation Center. Come on, I'll show you.
Okay, let's go in.
Well, Quesnel's sister city in Japan is Shirawi, and we like to remind the residents of Quesnel that we're into a twinning program. That means that we send people over to Shirawi, Japan, they send people back here. And when they come back here, they can see different symbols that they're all part of us. Shirawi Garden sponsors. And this is a part of the Shirawi Gardens that represents Japan, our sister city. That over there is the Stampede Grounds. They have the baseball games in the summertime and the stands and whatnot. All the larger ball teams that play in Quesnel play over in this area. If you look over there in the very distance, you can see some of the steam coming off from the pulp mill. The one across there,
right over there?
That one there, where you just see the steam coming over on the hill.
Yep.
Is one furthest north is Quesnel River pulp. The one not so far north is Cariboo pulp and paper. Those are the two main pulp mills, and this is a pulp town. The pulp industry and the forest industry is the major employer and the major thrust of the Cariboo. Second is tourism. Two pulp mills, Quesnel River pulp and Cariboo pulp and paper. Both of them are expanding right now. They supply most of the jobs. And there's about four sawmills after that. Large IWA contingent Quesnel. And then after that, tourism is our next industry.
Okay, Bruce, where are we going at now?
Okay, we're just going to take a meander over to Cariboo Pulp and Paper, one of our two pulp mills here in town, and just take a look and see what it's all about. What we're doing here is essentially illegal and immoral, but you see, all the pulp employees have a free car wash in order to get all the silt and stuff off their cars while at work. The unions put it in, and while I feel the company owes me a little something too, so we're going to go through Cariboo Pulp and Paper's free car wash. There we go.
That's the place you work, right there, right? Shooting this right at the moment.
Well,
Well, Dave, now we're going to go see the Pinnacles, one of the number one tourist attractions here in the Cariboo, and certainly in Quesnel. Now, a lot of this area used to be underwater at one time. And as years went by, Baker Creek here started eroding the soft soil. And the hard stuff, what was left, formed these pinnacles. And you see some of these in Banff National Park. The more spectacular here are these pinnacles.
That's where we just came from.
Here's where we are. Then you kind of jump.
We're up rather high here, 2,000 feet on a ledge with nothing to stop us from tripping or falling. Yeah, oh sure. Look at those pinnacles.
Yes, they are rather bright. That's why I took the iris lock off and I lost a picture there for a second. I get that. Now people have carved these.
No, that's not.
Yeah, look, some people have been putting stuff in.
Yeah, but look at this. See, these things are carved from many years ago, some of them. That's all the late stuff.
This is late.
But look at this. Some of this stuff is really hard. It's been carved like hundreds of years ago.
Yeah.
These have been carved by Indians. Great well. Shot.
We're seeing. Fun part, getting back up.
This is where all our news province-wide and nationwide and international comes on here. This is linked to CKNW in Vancouver. They operate and feed us all the provincial news. All the federal news comes from News Radio, and CKNW is a part of the BC headquarters for News Radio. And they feed to us that. There's about 10 other stations that feed to News Radio. And then they feed it back to us. So we get CKNW's news, all the member stations, there's about 30 of them, at least 30 in the province, are linked to this, and all the stations across the country. And our American affiliate is CBS and UPI. It used to be NBC, but we changed over around Christmas time. And that's where the hard copy comes over. Now we also take voice clips, which comes in on the satellite. There's a satellite monitor, nothing coming over right now. We'll get a warning on here, and a sketch of what's coming over. Then we'll take a cassette. Our station's different than most. Quite a few use carts. We use just cassettes, and these are the same things as normal cassette machines in the house. And we tape whatever's coming off the satellite feed, Just carrying it up here. And we can take whatever we want for voice material over. Fortunately, nothing's coming over, so I can't really show you what exactly is happening. And that's basically how that is done. We've got two typewriters here, so we can have two people working side by side. And when we're fully staffed, usually we have a desker, a pilot, and a co-pilot. And one might be working on local checks while one is working on the national and provincial news that's coming in. And then one's doing the announcing, you can switch back and forth. So usually we have two people in here. And when we line up our newscasts, we usually line them up here. So we'll have a skeleton cast for maybe 2 or 3 hours ahead of time. And then as new material comes in, we can keep on adding to it and taking out the stuff that's dated. And that's how that works.
2345 feed 1.
Okay, that's from Toronto. And that's taking a station from a member station in Edmonton. So we would take this right here and take it off.
The Alberta Weather Office has issued a heavy snowfall warning from southern Alberta to Red Deer, including the mountain region. Up to 20 centimeters of snow is expected to cover those areas. Edmonton Weather Office briefer Nick Benito.
Now, we have a choice. We can use this or we can skip it. Chances are we probably wouldn't use it because it's not as localized and doesn't have as much impact with us. We concentrate on local news. In order to get our local news, several things. We've got a filing system. Now, when we come across story ideas, possibly hear word about town that there might be a struggle, some strife, some labor problems, some alderman upset with something, we'll do up a check and we'll put it into our filing system here. This year's the announce booth. It's connected, wired in through the control room, which is next door. And this is where we do our newscast. Talk switch, so.
Hey, get out of my room here.
See, that's a talk switch, so we can talk back and forth and find out what's going on between us and the announcer.
You should take him over to Randy Radio's house.
We bumped into him at 7-Eleven. This is where we do it. All our voice material is run in these cassette decks, the same ones that we tape it on out there.
So neat.
That's basically it. That wraps up the newsroom.
And there's music of Paul Young and Everything Must Change on Cariboo Radio. In Quesnel, it's 5 degrees. The Lake Town is at 3, a 100 Mile House at 2, and Prince George at 4 for the night. A few clouds, some isolated snow showers, lows around minus 2. It's time now for tax tips.
You see, if you look over there, there's two carts fired in there, and he's about to hit a split. One is going to Williams Lake now, and one is going to Quesnel.
What happened?
That's all controlled from there. Two green lights, two carts being fired. One for each station. Larry wrote here, make sure that the music is not too upbeat, and make sure that the rock and roll is not too far in there.
Yeah, especially tomorrow night, eh? I got a good lineup for tomorrow night.
What happens to your RRSP should you leave Canada? There's nothing
what are you playing tomorrow night
you
on your reel-to-reel program?
As a matter of fact, should you emigrate, you have 60 days from the end of that calendar year to still make a contribution.
Well, I got some lined up, but just a second.
If you withdraw funds from your RRSP, all proceeds will automatically be cut with a 25% non-resident withholding tax. On the other hand, if you leave the RRSP to maturity and convert the funds to an annuity or RRIF, the payment you receive will be subject to the 25% non-resident tax.
Good, fine.
So much for retiring to your villa along the Costa del Sol. It'll cost you 25% tax. A gory thought from Tax Tips 87.
F41. Okay, 6, 7, 8, 8, 8, 8.
Good afternoon, I'm Bruce Claggett with Cariboo Radio News. At a farewell gathering in Vancouver, outbound New Democrat leader Bob Skelly predicted Premier Bill VanderZam would be a single-term premier as people will start to turn away from his Oral Roberts image. Former MLA Alec McDonald presented Skelly with a set of bagpipes as a parting gift. A different man heading the provincial New Democrats won't change the party's fortune, so says Cariboo MLA Neil Vant. Vant does not think the NDP will be able to garner any more votes with NDP leadership contender Mike Harcourt at the helm. The Soak Great Cariboo politician isn't impressed with Harcourt's performance in the provincial legislature, but says the former Vancouver mayor may be able to boost the spirits of his party's MLAs. Vant adds he would welcome a positive attitude from the New Democrats. You're listening to Cariboo Radio News.
Try not to get too much in the car.
Where are you going to take
there? There's this.